Hello, my name is Matthias Carstens. We're here at the Frankfurt MusikMesse 2018, and I want to show you three new RME products. First one is the ADI-2 DAC. This high-end DA converter is the small brother of the ADI-2 Pro, and it's specialized on DA conversion, means playback, USB or SPDIF, and has two special headphone outputs, one smaller one for in-ear monitoring and one bigger one for the over-ear and on-ear headphones. And first RME product ever with a remote control. So I can show this one now in action. You can easily switch the unit on. It's now working in class compliant mode, connected to an Apple iPad, and I start the music here. You can see the spectral analyzer is displayed. So with the remote control, we can do the usual things like control the volume quick or in 0.5 dB steps, whatever you like. We can directly switch the inputs from USB to a speed of optical and coaxial. We have a mute button, of course. So no level anymore here on the output. And we have four programmable buttons. 1, 2, 3, and 4 can be programmed with 21 different actions or commands. So button number one from the factory is with mono on off. Number one is loudness on off. Loudness is one of the main popular features in this unit. Number three is auto dark. Auto dark means the whole unit switches off the display and the illumination. It's still working. So if you see here, still working. Now it takes 10 seconds to switch off again, but let's go to the next one. Number four is dim. So there are about 21 commands or actions that you can program these four buttons to, 1 to 4. And just to show that for number four, we go here into the setup, hardware and diagnosis. We go down to the remote, remap keys for remote, that is this one. Then button number four here, and then I choose a different command like toggle view. Well, that means if I now switch button number four, I can go to state overview, analyzer, and the volume screen. It's very easy to change and set up. This unit is also very unique on the market because we have a bass and treble control. So you can change the bass plus minus 6 dB directly, very quickly, and the treble as well. The settings for the treble can even be adjusted by the user. That means the corner frequency and the quality factor, the amount of how steep the filter is, can be adjusted to your liking. And additionally, we not only have this, we also have the EQ. And here in the EQ section, you can set up a 5-band parametric EQ so that your headphone is completely compensated to have the perfect sound that you want to have. So just to show this, it's very easy. Yeah? I change here, attenuation or gain, and then I change the frequency where I want to have this. And here I change the quality factor. It's very easy to use. One quick turn and we're back to 0 dB. So this unit has only one DA converter in it, but we have three outputs. We have the front phones outputs, the IEM and normal phones. And on the back we have XLR and TS. So if you plug in the headphone, you can see it's changed line out. All the back outputs are in effect. And these back outputs have their own EQ and bass treble settings. I try to show this now. I turn on the bass and treble to full. And when I plug in my headphone, I have a complete different parametric equalizer, effects, crossfeed, mono, whatever you set up. And also, you see, bass and treble is back to zero where it was before. And this is true for all the three outputs. So if you plug in a phone or an IEM, you can have a different equalizer again. The unit basically does what you expect it to do, but what most units unfortunately don't do, it stores the settings for every of these three outputs.